I'd like to call the organizational meeting of this Roseville City Council to order for Monday, November the 11th. At this time, the presentation of colors will be by Corporal Neil W. Reed, VFW Post 2358.
Would everybody please rise if you are able, put your hands over your heart. I will lead the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order of arms. Please be seated.
I'd like to thank Post 2358 for their participation this evening. And at this time, today is Veterans Day, so can we have a moment of silence for all the warriors that lost their lives in the war to protect our nation and allow us to have a system and a democracy like we have today? Thank you. At this time, we'll have the invocation, Pastor James A. Friedman of the Greater Christian Ministry. Pastor, good evening.
Good evening, sir. First of all, congratulations to each and every one of you, and we want to remember all of our veterans. Let us bow our heads just for a moment, please. Dear Lord, first of all, we say thank you for the brave men and women that have served this country diligently, and some that have made ultimate sacrifices. We ask that you remember them and their families. And we ask also that we never forget the legacy and the memory of those that have given their lives for the sake of the freedom of our country. We pray, continue to pray for our active men and women in uniform today. We also thank you for this council and this government that recognizes you in every meeting before they start. We ask that you bless them for that, and also bless the city of Roseville. We thank you for the business that will be done here at hand. We thank you for each and every candidate and individual here that now sits to represent the constituents of this city and the citizens of this city also. We ask, Lord, that you direct them and lead them, give them the wisdom that they need in order to do the job that you have called them for. In Romans 13, the Apostle Paul commanded us to pray for those that you have placed in power. You said in your word, promotions come not from the east, west, or from the south, but promotion comes from you. You set up one, and you bless them with the wisdom to do what they need to do. We ask that you bless this city, every business, every church, every citizen, every homeowner, everyone that worship, works, and play here in the city of Roseville. This we say thank you for, in your precious name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor. At this time, I would like to introduce some elected officials and the department heads and school officials that are in the audience today. Judge Joseph Bodecker. We have our city department heads, City Manager Scott Aikens, Assistant City Manager and Controller Bob Cady, DPW Director Tom Iuto, Fire Chief Michael Holland, IS Director Phil Longell, Community and Economic Administrator Mike Connors. And from our schools, which we have a great relationship, we have Teresa Janae, the president. We have Ruth Green, a trustee. Kevin Switnowski, a trustee. And from the unions, we have Brian Schulte from the supervisors union. Okay, with that, we will go into the installation of newly elected officials. Oh, I'm sorry. my good friend Harold Haas, state representative. And since they said that, and our retired treasurer, Kathy Haas, and her deputy, Joan Logie. Okay, at this time, we will do the installation of newly elected officials. And Mr. Clerk, do you get sworn in first?
I do, Mayor.
Okay.
Well, the perks of being the clerk.
You seem to know more what I know.
Rich, I'm sure you're happy to have your family here today. Your two lovely daughters, unfortunately, Mrs. Steenland couldn't be here, but hopefully she'll be the men very soon.
For all those watching or concerned, my wife had back surgery this morning. Everything went very well. She's resting comfortably, and I'm sure she would much rather be here swearing at me, or swearing me in, than laying in the hospital. She did say,
what?
My daughter is so proud. But anyway, my wife did express to everybody that she's doing well and wish all the newly elected officials well.
All right, I've heard that.
I was just waving my friend.
The mark of a good elected official is one of them get reelected. And obviously, you've done a good job in the city of Roseville. You've been reelected many times as city councilman and city clerk. So it's my privilege to be able to swear you in for yet another term as city clerk. So please raise your right hand. Aye.
Richard M. Steenland.
Do solemnly swear. That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
The Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office of city clerk.
The duties of the office of city clerk.
Serving in and for the city of Roseville.
Serving in and for the city of Roseville.
County of Macomb.
County of Macomb.
State of Michigan.
State of Michigan.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. It's an honor to stand before everybody here tonight. It's also an honor to be standing here being sworn in by Judge Bodecker, who I grew up with Joe's brother, who unfortunately passed away many, many years ago in a severe car accident. But I watched Joe grow up going through law school, and we'd be in the room playing, and Joe'd be coming home to study and kick us out of the house. And we weren't doing anything that bad, but in any event, it's quite a privilege to have you swear me in, Joe. I appreciate it. Thank you. At this point, I would like to introduce my entire staff that's here tonight. I'd like to call up Jennifer Zelmansky, my deputy clerk, and I'd also like to introduce Mary Watisha, my entire staff. Without these two, I'm going to tell you, I got two of the best city employees. We've done a lot of creativity in the clerk's office. We've streamlined the process. I'm proud to say that we've eliminated we consolidated precincts. We introduced the new laptop computers. We took on a lot of new activity this election. In consolidating those precincts, it was a lot of work to undertake. We're in the process of trying to hire police officers, firefighters, all with the three of us in the office. And I'd just like to say publicly that I'm very proud to have these two in my office. Without them, and they're both wearing purple, by the way, I just noticed. This is kind of good. Anyhow, Jennifer, if you'd raise your right hand, repeat after me, please. I, Jennifer Zelmansky. Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
The Constitution of the State of Michigan.
I will faithfully discharge.
And I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the office of Deputy City Clerk.
The duties of office of Deputy City Clerk.
And not be late for work. I'm sorry. City of Roseville.
City of Roseville.
County of Macomb.
County of Macomb.
State of Michigan.
State of Michigan.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
Congratulations. Thank you very much. At this point, I'd like to call up Mayor Chirkin. Elect, that is. He's not the mayor yet until I swear him. And for the good news out there, as you guys all know, every election we seem to have some kind of an injury story. Good news is, Nobody got hurt this election. Last time he wound up with stitches, and I wound up with stitches, and Bobby got bit by a dog, and anyhow, it goes on and on. You sure you want to do this again?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
But before I
start, you may.
No, just, you know, Judge Bodecker, you're lucky he was getting sworn in by you and not standing in front of you.
That was a long time ago, man. I, John Churkin, do solemnly swear.
I, John Churkin, do solemnly swear.
And affirm.
And affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And I will faithfully discharge.
And I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of the Office of Mayor.
The duties of the Office of Mayor.
In and for.
In and for.
The City of Roseville.
The City of Roseville.
County of Macomb.
County of Macomb.
State of Michigan.
State of Michigan.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my abilities.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Mayor. Board from the mayor.
Yeah, you know, I've been here 19 years, and every time I get elected, it's a new experience. And I'm hoping around the corner that the economy picks up and the taxes, our tax base gets bigger so we can hire more people to make the city like it used to be when I first got on council. This time I'd like to introduce my wife, Sharon, my son, Jonathan, my daughter, Denise, my granddaughter, Savannah, my grandson, Bryce, my son-in-law, Chris, and River, my nephew.
And I guess I forgot to introduce my two daughters that are here tonight, Anna and Julia, if you could just stand up. I love it when I do that. My son, Ricky's in away at college at Miami University. Oh, I'm sure he's studying tonight. Anyhow. If I could have Councilman Shoemaker.
Yep.
The next couple individuals I'm about to swear in is all graduates of Carl Brablick High School. A couple of us did make it.
I made it.
I know, but I know it cost your parents dearly. Anyhow, I, Bill Shoemaker.
I, Bill Shoemaker.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear and affirm
that I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And that I will faithfully discharge.
And I will faithfully discharge
the duties of the Office of Councilman.
The duties of the Office of Councilman.
Serving in and for the City of Roseville.
Serving for in and for the City of Roseville.
County of Macomb.
County of Macomb.
State of Michigan.
State of Michigan.
Gratiot.
Gratiot.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my.
You guys know why I did that.
Thank
congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes, Councilman Shoemaker.
Well, I thank everybody that supported me this past election. This is my fifth term, and my family's not here tonight, but I do appreciate all their support. I guess kind of like old hat. My friend Karen Wojak is here, and also want to announce that Charles Frontera is in the audience. Thank you.
I could have Councilman Aiuto. Sam and I graduated, Billy graduated a year after us. Sam and I graduated the same year. That was the best 3 years of my life, that 12th grade.
I'm not saying.
Please raise your right hand, repeat after me. I, Salvatore Aiuto.
I, Salvatore Aiuto.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And I will faithfully discharge the duties of the Office of Councilman.
And I will faithfully discharge the duties of Office of Councilman.
Serving in and for the City of Roseville.
Serving in and for the City of Roseville.
County of Macomb.
County of Macomb.
State of Michigan.
State of Michigan.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you, everyone. I just want to introduce my son, Alex, my wife, Beth, out in the audience. And thanks for all your support.
I could have Councilwoman Haggerty. You bring your dog tonight?
I wanted to.
I figured you did. Janet's always walking the dog up and down the neighborhood. Anyhow, I, Janet Hagerty.
I, Janet Hagerty.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And I'll faithfully discharge the duties of.
And I'll faithfully discharge the duties of.
The office of councilwoman.
The office of councilwoman.
Serving in and for the city of Roseville.
Serving in and for the city of Roseville.
County of Macomb.
County of Macomb.
State of Michigan.
State of Michigan.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
I also would like to thank everybody that supported me, and I'm excited to be here, that we can continue doing the job that we all have set out to do. We've got a good team, and we want to keep it going. And I did want to bring my dog Daisy, but they won't let her in, so thank you.
If I could have Treasurer-elect Councilman, Commissioner, State Representative, Dog Catcher, MIT guy. Here's a guy who's done pretty much everything that I can. Hi, Michael Swatowski.
Hi, Michael Swatowski.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And I'll faithfully discharge the duties of.
And I will faithfully discharge the duties of.
The office of city treasurer.
The office of city treasurer.
Serving in and for the city of Roseville.
Serving in and for the city of Roseville.
County of Macomb.
County of Macomb.
State of Michigan.
State of Michigan.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations. The nice thing about this, the councilman hadn't ride yet, so I was able to use the same one.
Thank you. Thank you, Rich. And let me start by saying, I enjoyed my time on the council. I loved serving with you guys. I think we did a great job. I'm really proud of what we accomplished. We had some tough things to go through, and I think we did well. So I'm going to miss y'all. Let me start by introducing my family. My 87-year-old mother is homesick on the couch, but you know, she would have been here. But my wife, Roma, is here. Imported from Scotland, and my nephew, Andrew, imported from Baltimore. I really am so fortunate the way the election played out. I was unopposed. So without being presumptuous, I got to come in and learn the job during the fall and really get trained by the best. I'm lucky it worked out this way because the treasurer position is really very detailed work and is a great responsibility. Kathy Haw, Joan Logie, and Katie Gunvalson have shown dedication, professionalism, and patience during this transition period. Kathy Haw has done a superb job as treasurer and has been and continues to be extremely helpful to me, Kathy. I only hope that I can measure up to the high standard that Kathy and her predecessor, the late, great Eddie Knoll, set. Joan Logie will be retiring soon, despite my constant begging and bargaining with her to stay. Joan's 36 years with the city and comprehensive knowledge of treasurer office operations and history are not easily replaced. She has a great spirit and a joie de vivre. I am grateful for the valuable time we share before she retires near the end of the year. Both she and Kathy will return on occasion for special projects. I thank God every day that I have Katie Gunvalson, who I see as the backbone of the department. Katie can do every job and has served the city over 20 years in various departments. Along the way, she's picked up an impressive set of skills, and I will rely on her constantly. Katie's a shining example of what citizens want from government. She's a public servant that gets the job done accurately, efficiently, and with an engaging smile. Both I and the people of Roseville are lucky to have her. So filling Joan Logie's shoes will be difficult, but tonight I am naming Carla Haxter as my deputy treasurer. I do this with a feeling of satisfaction because I know that she is the best. I have known her since I was 6 years old. She worked for 13 years at Comerica Bank on 12 and Grosbeck, and for the last 15 years at Alcar Steel on Callahan north of 12. Carla is dyed in the wool Roseville. She has lived her entire life within a one-mile radius of Utica Junction. The treasurer's office opens up at the crack of dawn, and Carla loves to get up early and has a work ethic second to none. I am so fortunate that she was willing to leave her job at Alcar to be my deputy. So are the people of Roseville. Finally, thanks to the people of Roseville for entrusting me with this position. I will work hard to maintain the excellent tradition that you deserve. Thank you. And I know your deputy probably wants to introduce her family, and I'm sure Carla does.
Did you want this, Mick, or are you just going to let it? And I do thank you, Mick, and I did neglect to give Jennifer the opportunity to introduce her family. If you'd like to, please do so.
My dear Mr. Zolansky, my mother, Mrs. Zolansky, my boyfriend, Jordan, and my close friends.
And everybody knows Jim Zolansky was a councilman for many years. Well, was it the people's voice? Or no, the voice of the people. The voice of the people by Jim Zolansky. And at this point, last but not least, if I can have Carla Haxter come to the podium, please. I don't know her that well, so I can't pick at her too much. You look very nice. I'm Rich Steenland.
She's taller than you, too.
Wait till I get him back. He ain't seen nothing. Carla, if you please raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Carla Haxter.
I, Carla Haxter.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And the Constitution of the State of Michigan.
And I'll faithfully discharge.
And I'll faithfully discharge.
The duties of the Office of Deputy City Treasurer.
The duties of the Deputy
City Treasurer.
City Treasurer.
Serving in and for the City of Roseville.
Serving in and for the City of Roseville.
County of Macomb.
County of Macomb.
State of Michigan.
State of Michigan.
According to the best of my ability.
According to the best of my ability.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations, Carla, and welcome aboard.
Of course, I have to follow that speech. No one told me I would be speaking. But I will do the honors of introducing my family. In the back row, I have my husband, going to be known as Mr. Carla Haxter. No, Dwayne Haxter. My son, Andrew, and my daughter-in-law, Jeanette, and my new grandbaby, Aubrey Francis. I have my mother-in-law, Sue Haxter. My father, Joe Bush. My brother, Joe Bush. We have his family and wife, Marie, Gina, Rebecca, Luke, Jessica, and Izzy. I think that's it. And I'm so pleased to have this opportunity to serve the city. And I have a lot of work to do, but Joan has agreed to stay on, and I really appreciate it. I'll see you at 7. Thank you.
$10. It was a test to see if anybody had your cellular devices turned on. You can tell the new person being sworn in tonight. We had to scrimp people together to come to see us. Carla, congratulations. You've won the prize for having the most people in the audience tonight. With that, I would like to thank everybody again. It's hard to tell that I'm hoping that the reason that myself, the mayor, and the treasurer ran unopposed is because our constituents are happy with the service and we're providing them. It's probably not true. People just don't want to be involved anymore, maybe. I don't know. In any event, I'd like to say congratulations to all the candidates for re-election, those who ran. Everybody ran a good campaign, and look forward to serving the City of Roseville and the citizens of Roseville for another 4 years. And Kathy Ha and Joni, Kathy's been my office mate since 2007. I've been here. We've spent many hours together and lunches and figuring things out, and trying to figure things out and not able to figure things out, and we're going to miss it every day. Kath and Joni, you guys have done an outstanding job for the city, and I'd like to thank you from my family to yours as well. And with that, I guess I don't get to say anymore because I usually don't get to talk, so this has been kind of neat. Mayor?
Thank you. Your 3 minutes are up.
My 3 minutes are up. Yeah. Thank you.
And the city does rent him out for bar mitzvahs and weddings and master of ceremonies for roasts. At this time is the hearing of the public. Is there anybody from the public that wishes to be heard this evening?
Your three Rich minutes. Steenland, 19.
Anybody from the public wish to be heard? Anybody from the public? Seeing none, we will go into new business. Discussion and or action regarding the council vacancy. Since our esteemed councilman, Michael Swatowski, was elevated to the position of trustee, we do have a vacancy on council. So anybody interested in the council vacancy, please notify the manager's office by 4 o'clock on Friday. The next item is adoption of rules of order. Mr. Manager, how do usually we do Robert's Rules of Order, right?
Absolutely, sir. We'd entertain a motion from council to adopt Robert's Rules of Order as the parliamentary rules for council.
Mayor, I'll make the motion to adopt Robert's Rules of Order as our rules of order.
Support.
Okay, I have a motion by Councilman Ayuto, supported by Councilwoman Haggerty. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next is selection of parliamentarian. Usually we elect the city attorney for the parliamentarian, so can I have a motion for that, please?
So moved.
Motion by Councilwoman McCartney, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor, to adopt the city attorney, Mr. Tim Tomlinson, as our parliamentarian. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. The next item is selection of the Mayor Pro Tem.
May I make the motion to keep Bob Taylor as the Mayor Pro Tem? I support that.
I have a motion by Councilwoman McCartney, supported by Councilwoman Haggerty, to elect Councilman Robert Taylor to Mayor Pro Tem again. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Congratulations, Mayor Pro Tem.
Thank you, Mayor.
Our next item is members of City Council to be heard. Usually I start at this end, but tonight I'm going to let Councilwoman McCartney go first.
I just want to congratulate everybody for running a great campaign. And congratulations to all of you. Mickey, congratulations. Kathy and Joni, good luck in your retirement. That's all I have.
Thank you. Councilwoman Haggerty.
Well, thank you, Mayor. Again, thank you for everyone that supported me. I'd like to congratulate Joan Logie and Kathy Hall on their part-time retirements. And I'm looking forward to the next 4 years. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilman Shoemaker.
Thank you, Mayor. Congratulations to all of us that was reelected, and congratulations to Mickey. You are now newly elected as city treasurer, and it was a pleasure working with you as well. And also enjoy your retirement, both Kathy and Joni. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you. Councilman Ayuto.
Thank you, Mayor. I'm going to just say the same things. I did want to say, as I did the last couple times I got reelected, to thank Judge Santia for his encouraging words many years ago when I needed to hear them, and I just wanted to thank him very much. I also wanted to also acknowledge the veterans, any that are here tonight and those that are watching, to thank you for your service to our country and that we can all sit here because of you. So thank you very much. Again, thanking my friends and family. I didn't mention my brother Tom earlier, and I'm going to mention my wife, Maggie, and my son, Alex. So he keeps saying, mention me. So wave, Alex, to everybody again. There you go. And now he wants me to stop talking because he wants to go get some juice and some cheese. So congratulations to Mickey on his upgrade. And thank you, Kathy Haw and Joni Logie, for your service all these many years. So thank you all. Thank you, Beth. And take care of each other.
Thank you. Mayor Pro Tem Taylor.
I guess I'd like to echo everybody else's statements here. I'd like to congratulate all the newly elected officials and Mayor Churkin on a very successful election. Our city clerk, Mr. Steelen, congratulations. Mickey,
We're going to miss you up here. We've gained a lot of knowledge from you, and I appreciate everything that you did for the city and for this council. So congratulations. I'm glad you're still in our city, because we're always going to be able to lean on you. We know where you're at. Kathy and Joan, you know, we're going to miss you guys. You guys do a great job, and you guys have always did a great job. And but that's Roseville. That's what we do. So I appreciate everything you guys have did. Folks that are out here today, thanks for coming out. This is a wonderful event. We got great people up here on this council. We got great people in the city, and it's only because of you folks. You folks elect us. You guys, you know, show up at these events, and we appreciate that stuff. Your support means a lot to us. So on that, I'd like to have a good night.
Thank you. Once again, I'd like to thank my family. They've supported me all these years, and they've watched the ups and downs of the city too, but they've always been there for me, and I really appreciate that. And I got my two grandkids in here. Maybe one day they might be sitting up here. I don't know. But anyways, I'd like to thank all my friends and my supporters over the years. They put their trust in me all these years, and I really appreciate it. And like I said, the city's on the rebound now. We're doing the right things to make it work. And I'd like to say a little shout out to former Councilman Jim Zelmansky. Jimmy and me, we go way back, and I wouldn't be sitting up here if it wasn't for him. So, Jim, thank you. And with that, have a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Hagerty, supported by Council Mayor Pro Tem Taylor. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. We are adjourned.